Hello everybody and welcome to my video series on how to play Pokémon. Do you enjoy Pokémon? Do you want to enjoy Pokémon? Would you like to learn more about how it works and get a leg up on fellow trainers? Is reading words and sentences simply too boring and sleep-inducing? If you answered yes to any of these questions, congratulations, this video might be relevant to your interests. I'm here to teach you the ins and outs of the massive world of Pokémon. Battling, breeding, training. I plan on covering a large variety of topics, from the barebone basics to some more advanced competitive insight. So strap in, don your respective learning apparatuses, and prepare to get schooled. So being that this is episode 1, and also because I literally just said that I'm going to be covering everything starting with the barebone basics, let's start with the barebone basics. Pokemon is an RPG series that's been around since the late 90s. The basic premise of the game is to catch, train, and battle Pokemon or pocket monsters. Trainers battle with up to 6 Pokemon on their team in one of several different battle modes, and they battle until they faint the opposing team's Pokemon. Last one standing is the winner. Seems pretty simple, right? At a glance, Pokemon looks like a kid's game, and it always has, and that's mainly because the target demographic is kids. But beneath the surface lies a complex RPG with very elaborate mechanics that allow for unique strategies and countless combinations that keeps casual newcomers and competitive veterans alike coming back for more. So as of right now, we're currently in the 6th generation of Pokemon. A generation can be summed up as a bracket of 3 or 4 core series Pokemon titles that were released around the same time, took place in the same area or region of the Pokemon world, and introduced a set number of Pokemon to the Pokédex. It should also be known that every title in the core series of Pokemon games has been released on a handheld Nintendo console. So now it's time for a history lesson. With the exception of Generation 5, each generation has had 3 games, 2 that were released initially as a pair, and a 3rd that was released later as a sort of special edition that brought the 2 together. The 2 games had version-exclusive Pokemon that could only be caught in that version, and therefore required you to trade with the opposite version to collect them all. So here's the big one that started them all, Generation 1. The first 2 games were Pokemon Red Version and Pokemon Blue Version. These 2 were known as Pokemon Red Version and Pokemon Green Version over in Japan. The complementary 3rd version for Generation 1 was the Special Pikachu Edition, informally known as Yellow Version. Generation 1 took place in the Kanto region and introduced the first batch of Pokemon to the world, 151 of them to be exact. These 3 titles were initially released for the Nintendo Game Boy. Generation 2 introduced Pokemon Gold Version and Pokemon Silver Version, and concluded with Pokemon Crystal Version. 100 new Pokemon were introduced in the region of Johto, bringing the number of total Pokemon up to 251. Pokemon Crystal was the first Pokemon game where players were given the choice between a male or a female protagonist. These games were made available for the Game Boy Color. Generation 3 brought us Pokemon Ruby, Pokemon Sapphire, and Pokemon Emerald, this time for the Game Boy Advance. We saw the addition of 135 Pokemon this time around, climbing our national Pokédex up to 386 and adding the Hoenn region to the world map. In addition to these games, however, Game Freak released updated remakes of the first generation games called Fire Red and Leaf Green, a nod to the Japanese releases. These games, while undergoing a graphical update to keep up with the Game Boy Advance's graphics, were updated to contain all of the mechanics of the third generation, as well as all 386 Pokémon that were current as of that point. The fourth generation of Pokemon consisted of Pokemon Diamond, Pokemon Pearl, and Pokemon Platinum, bringing the series to the Nintendo DS. This generation brought us 107 new Pokemon from the Sinnoh region for a grand total of 493. The overworld was given a slightly 3D perspective, a first for a handheld Pokemon game. Generation 4 also graced us with the long-awaited Heart Gold and Soul Silver, remakes of the Generation 2 games, also released for the Nintendo DS. Similarly to Fire Red and Leaf Green, Heart Gold and Soul Silver gave the Generation 2 games a fresh graphical update, as well as updates to the current generation's mechanics and Pokédex. Now, if you remember earlier, I stated that Generation 5 was the first exception to the formula that we'd grown accustomed to over the years. As per the usual tradition, this generation introduced us to a new region, Unova, as well as 156 new Pokemon, making the total number 649. At first we got Pokemon Black and Pokemon White, but here's where they changed things up a little bit. Instead of a third installment, we got 2 new installments, simply called Black 2 and White 2. The difference here is that instead of a special edition that helped to bridge the gap between the 2 initial installments of the generation, these 2 were actually direct sequels to the first games. They took place years after the originals with new protagonists and a new storyline. Fifth generation is the first to this date where we saw 4 core series games instead of 3. Pokemon Black and White also introduced some major aesthetic changes, including fully animated Pokemon and a dynamic camera that moved around as the battle progressed. Alright, fast forward to the present day. So like I said earlier, right now we're currently in the 6th generation of Pokemon. So far this generation has brought us Pokemon X and Pokemon Y. This generation takes place in the Kalos region, which gave us our most recent batch of only 70 new Pokemon, making the current number of total Pokemon a whopping 719. So now that you know a little more about the series, we can move on to the actual game mechanics. In the next episode, I'm going to introduce you to Pokemon types and the type chart. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.